All right, Shalom. First off, I want to give all praise, honor, infinite glory to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh, Shai, Bashem, Kakadash, the bonds of the apostles and the elders of great millstone who rule well in citation to the elect to push the truth in all sincerity. Sincere Shalom to hopeful elect to keep your garments clean and does the will of Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh, Shai. The one of Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh, Shai for allowing us to do another video. I'm the brother Tawab and this is the brother
Zakar.
Today's video, I want to talk about Omicron. All right, so in this video, okay, basically going into, I have a video, okay, it's basically talking about how there's a new variant, as we already know, okay, it's called Omicron, okay, and he saw Edom, he's predicting that this variant, okay, is more contagious, okay, and the video that I got up here, basically, Esau Edom, he's saying that the Omicron variant, okay, it spreads twice as fast, okay? Yeah. So, we obviously know about Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh, Shai, okay, controlling everything. You know, the Lord, okay, he's looking to put damage in this place, okay? We know that the Lord, okay, that he's going to be putting out pestilence, okay? See? And now, and the thing is, this CV-19 shit, right? The CV-19 is not even close, okay, to the grand pestilence, okay, that the Lord has in store, okay? See, this is just a small thing, okay? See? More people gonna get it, you know? You know, drop dead from it and whatnot, okay? Esau's gonna, you know, push more of his rhetoric. Oh, shit, the pandemic is getting worse. We need to extend it even more in terms of like, we need to, you know, it's gonna be harder to get rid of and shit. See, he talks about, oh, we're doing good. And then he goes and says, oh, shit, now things are spreading more. Oh, we're doing good. Oh, now people are not getting vaccinated. So that means, so now things are getting worse. So he keeps playing that game like things are good. With the so-called pandemic, then things get worse, okay? So this is another ploy, okay? Esau talking about, okay, we are doing great with the Delta, things are gonna go away, and then, oh no, Omicron's here, see? So Esau, Edom, he keeps playing that damn fence, that damn game, you see? You know? And then Omicron, see? Esau's obviously gonna play on that, okay? See, because he wants the pandemic, he wants this stupid ass pandemic to keep going, okay? See, he wants to play on that, he wants it to keep going, keep pushing, okay? Okay, you see through the spirit that Esau, he's not letting up on this one, okay? See, he's not letting up on this opportunity, okay, to be pushing more draconian laws, be pushing, okay, towards his new world order, okay? See? See what I'm saying? Simple as that, okay? So this new variant, okay, Esau, okay, like I already said, the spirit Esau, he's looking to obviously push, okay, this pandemic to the maximum, okay, all the way right into his new world order, okay, all the way right into the RFID microchip, okay, simple as that, okay, there's so much more things coming out with the RFID microchip, okay, you see? So, got this video, I played the video, got three presets, and that'll be the end.
Warning that the new Omicron coronavirus variant is likely to delay the global economic recovery from the pandemic. The fund is expecting to downgrade its forecasts for world growth this year and next. And that's even though the World Health Organization says it has no evidence yet of any deaths connected to Omicron. The new variant is spreading rapidly in many countries. South Africa, in particular, is seeing an alarming wave of infections. More young children are being hospitalized, and authorities are concerned that people who've already had COVID-19 are being reinfected. Healthcare workers in South Africa have had their hands full since scientists there first detected the Omicron variant last week. And it's been found across South Africa.
We are also now experiencing such a rapid surge in case numbers that it is actually quite frightening. I am moderately confident that the country will be able to cope. On the other hand, the rapidly increasing numbers are a nasty surprise, and I wonder what the future holds for us.
Just a quarter of the population have been fully vaccinated. But it's not clear yet how far the current vaccines protect against an infection with Omicron.
We are seeing a lot of breakthrough infections in vaccinees, which is, of course, a worry. We are also seeing reinfections in people who had previously been infected during one of the previous waves. But the majority of infections so far are mild. That said, we have to say that it's still early days, and as we know, to become clinically severe, they will have to be 10 to 14 days or more after becoming infected. So it's probably too early to tell.
South Africa's public health authorities warn that more children and young adults are being hospitalized with the coronavirus. Many countries have placed new restrictions on travelers from South Africa and even shut borders. And the scientists who alerted the world to the Omicron variant are facing a backlash at home.
But critics within the country that is now very hard hit by all these travel bans, they are blaming us, the scientists, for actually doing sequencing and sharing our results, which I think is quite misguided.
Face masks are mandatory, and there are limits on the number of people who can attend indoor and outdoor gatherings. But Omicron continues its invisible race across South Africa. And for more, we can speak to journalist and molecular biologist Kai Kupferschmidt, who joins us from here in Berlin. It's good to have you on the program again. Now, scientists say the Omicron variant is spreading more than twice as quickly as the Delta variant. We just heard there more kids are being hospitalized. How worried do we really need to be?
Well, I think so. Scientists are still trying to get a clearer picture of what exactly Omicron has in store. You know, imagine a big puzzle and we're only just getting the first puzzle pieces, but certainly those first puzzle pieces, you know, all add to the concern. We now have some preliminary data that shows that this virus can in fact reinfect people, certainly people who've gone through an infection before and recovered. And it does seem to be spreading very fast, though that's always very hard to tell in the early days whether there are, you know, certain super spreading events, for instance, that make it appear to be spreading faster than it actually will in the long run. But certainly, I think if we've learned anything from the last 2 years is that in a situation like this, you know, we should rather act fast and be worried right now and then, you know, breathe a sigh of relief if it doesn't turn out to be as bad.
Right. Now, the World Health Organization is saying that it has no evidence of any deaths linked to Omicron. Yet countries are racing to impose stricter pandemic measures. Travel bans are in place. Would you say all of these restrictions are an overreaction?
So I don't think it's an overreaction. I do think that travel bans, you know, you have to be very careful about what you do with travel bans. All they do is buy you a little bit of time, and they only make sense for a very short time, because once the virus spreads, you know, wide in your own communities anyway, it doesn't really make sense to impose them, and they have a, you know, fairly big cost attached to them. So, but the fact that we haven't seen any deaths so far in South Africa from Omicron doesn't really tell us that much yet, because it's still really early days. We know that it takes, you know, 2 weeks for people once they go to the hospital and then for deaths actually to be reported. So I think at the moment I wouldn't read too much into it. I mean, we're all kind of hoping that maybe, you know, it does turn out to be a milder variant that spreads fast but is milder, but we really can't say that at the moment, and we certainly shouldn't pin our hopes on that and not act and prepare.
Okay, so obviously there's a lot more to learn about this variant, but of course Omicron is the latest in a string of coronavirus mutations since the start of the pandemic. Do we need to prepare ourselves for a potentially never-ending series of new mutations? Or, you know, is there anything that governments around the world could be doing better to try and bring this to an end?
Well, what's very clear is that as long as this virus can spread in this, you know, huge amount of people that it is spreading in at the moment, mutations will keep arising, and some of those mutations will give this virus advantages, whether in transmissibility or in reinfecting people. It might get around vaccine immunity. And that's just something that we have to live with unless we really try to do the hard work of suppressing the numbers. I mean, we do have some experience with a virus that keeps changing. That's the flu. And of course, it might very well be that this turns into a virus that stays with us. That's certainly what it looks like, that SARS-CoV-2 will be with us for the long run. But even then, we are going to have to do the hard work of making sure that we're prepared for every season when it comes and just hope that it does indeed over time become a little bit milder. But that's by no means a given.
All right, Kai Kupfer-Schmidt, as ever, thank you so much.
So there you go, okay. You know, Esau, okay. He basically doesn't know too much about it, okay. He said that maybe it can be less dangerous, but it just spreads faster. You know, he doesn't know too much about it, okay. But either way, the moment I put another variant, okay, the more people can get it, okay. See, and just, you know, be messed up by it, okay. You see, like I said, Esau doesn't know too much about it, but either way, the most is obviously putting the spirit, putting that pestilent out there, okay, this variant, okay, to producing more, extending the pandemic, okay, keeping that vibration, okay, on planet Earth, okay, see, that vibration, that vibration of just, you know, draconian, strict, okay, see, people, a lot of people are scared, okay, so most of us keeping that vibration on there, okay, having that variant out. Okay, these people are talking about, oh, we're done, we're about to be down Delta. Now Omicron came. See, you see what I'm saying? So this is what the most size thing to do, and we continuously say in every single video. Okay, worldwide, the most size looking to do judgment. He's looking to do damage. He's looking to do destruction. Okay, this is intent. Okay, for the evil of this place, for the satanic behavior of this place. Okay, this is what this place deserves. Okay, see. It's that simple, you know what I'm saying? It's just that plain and simple, okay? You know, if you're not with the Abba Shemiel Shai, if you're not getting down the program, the Most High could get you, okay? And you don't want the Most High to get you. The scripture says it's a fearful thing to fall into the powers, into the hand of the living God, okay? You don't want the Abba Shemiel Shai, okay, to be looking at you angry. You don't want that, okay? Simple as that, okay? See? So, there's a new variant out there, okay? See? And Esau, he looks like he's shaking his boots because of it, okay? And that's that, okay? Look at the precepts.
This is Luke 21:11. And great earthquakes shall be in diverse places, and famines, and pestilences, and fearful sights, and great signs shall be there, be from heaven.
So there you go, pestilences, okay? Pestilences, sicknesses, diseases, and whatnot, okay? And like I said, through spirit, it could be way much worse ones. A disease that you get and you just drop dead, okay? Really gruesome diseases, okay? See what I'm saying? Not this little baby ass super cold, okay? It's the super flu. Not this shit, okay? But still, obviously, this is an example of a pestilence, though. See? As scripture just said, people say, oh, the Bible doesn't exist. Oh, everything it says is bullshit. What does the Bible have to do with today? Fucking dumbass idiot, okay? Just said right there, pestilence will be in the end times, okay? And what do we see pestilence? This is just a very simple equation, okay? But people are just literally just stupid fools, okay? The most I block them, okay? See what I'm saying? People act like they're wise, they're smart. Ain't no one wise, okay? Only the men of Yahba Shemiel Shai, okay? Those are true wise men, okay? Simple as that, okay? I'll say again, the only ones, the true wise men is the men of Yahba Shemiel Shai, okay? The only ones that have a mind to actually think, okay? See, is the elect, okay? Simple as that, okay? You know? See, the prophets are the true ultimate wise men, okay? See? The 144, that's the government, okay, of the kingdom of heaven, okay? So obviously they're the ultimate wise men, okay? The 144 prophets, okay? You see, that's the number one, okay? You know, So the elect, the only ones could have the intellect to understand scriptures. Okay, see, so pestilence. Okay, this COVID bullshit. Okay, is a pestilence. Okay, the one may be weak. Okay, see. So next piece up.
This is 2 Ezra 15 and verse 49. I will send plagues upon thee.
I'll send plagues upon thee. Okay, the Most High wants to send plagues. Okay, see? There's many different types of plagues. There's famine. Okay, there's a sword. Okay, see? There's obviously pestilence. Okay, there's many different types of plagues the Most High wants to send. And not only does he want to send, but he's actually sending now. Okay, he's doing it right now. Okay, this place has been plagued with all sorts of types of different avenues of destruction. Okay, see, all the way to the point where this place is just through, finished, just in a state ready just to be nuked. Okay, be hit and burnt by thermonuclear fire, and to be burnt also by the chariots. Okay, see, which you peons call UFOs. Okay. No, UFOs, they believe in UFOs. You damn right, okay? And it's not what you think it is. Green men in there, okay? Not that stupid shit, okay, that you lied about, okay? There's angels in there, okay, that look like so-called black spanking the American men, okay? Read it again.
I will send plagues upon thee. Widowhood, poverty, famine, sword, and pestilence.
Pestilence, okay? Pestilence. Okay, this is what this the Most High saying, pestilence. There's gonna be diseases out here. Okay, there's gonna be sicknesses out here. Okay, you see, the Most High wants to push sicknesses out here. It's just that simple. Okay, we have this Novich bull. Okay, we have this Delta variant. And what did the Most High do? What did he do? He put Omicron. Okay, you see. So you see clearly the Most High, he's pushing, what is he doing? He's pushing the spirit of pestilence. He's putting pestilence out, okay? You have Delta, and what do? He put Omicron. Why? Because the Most High is pushing pestilence. And so there's going to be another pestilence coming. It's that simple, okay? This is that plain as day, okay? There's going to be another pestilence that comes, okay? You see? But that's what the Most High is wanting to do, okay? Why? Which I already said, through the spirit, to put destruction, okay? See, this place needs to go. Okay, this wicked ass satanic place needs to go. Okay, it needs to be destroyed completely. Okay, see, this place can't continue to be running. Okay, you can't run a society on wickedness. Okay, you have a bunch of undesirables. Okay, the alphabet community. You can't run a society with alphabet people. You can't run a society with thoughts and whores. Okay, with whoredom. You can't run a society like that. Okay. You see, it's just that plain, okay? And it's just, man. And you can't run aside, obviously, in wickedness, okay? You got a bunch of adulterers out, thugs, stealers, okay? All men of wickedness is out here, okay? People that do witchcraft, okay? See, hidden and out in the open, okay? You see? So obviously the Most I want to destroy this place, okay? And he's going to judge every single person, okay? That's obviously off. To the last precept.
2 Ezra chapter 16 and verse 18. The beginning of sorrows and great mournings. The beginning of famine and great death. The beginning of wars and the power shall stand in fear. Beginning of evils, what shall I do when these evils shall come?
So the Most High put another pestilence, okay, another variant, okay, the Omicron, okay. But this is still just the beginning, though, okay. This is still just the beginning. This is just the beginning, still, okay. You see, this is just the tip, okay, of the iceberg, you could say, okay. It's still the beginning, okay? The Most High has a lot of judgment he's unraveled. The Most High is angry. He's extremely mad, okay? And obviously, the elect is pissed as well, okay? He's obviously in the spirit of Yahweh Hashem Yahshai, okay? So the Most High being mad, Now, obviously, the Most High is on a different level. Like, hey, man, you think that you're mad? Oh, man, you're not mad. Okay, the Most High, he's mad, okay? See, Yahbash Me'ashah, he's mad, okay? You see? Obviously, the elect being in the spirit of Yahweh, Yahshai, obviously, they're mad too, okay? See? They're mad at seeing it and being vexed. The scriptures talk about that, okay? Lot being vexed with the filthy conversation of the wicked every day, okay? It says righteous soul being vexed, okay, from what he was seeing and hearing from wicked people, just like us. That's exactly like us. You go to work, you hear the craziness that Jake talks about, the behavior Jake acts and all that, okay? The other nations too, okay? And it's just vexing as hell, man. It's vexing as hell, okay? These people can outrightly just be their nasty ass unruly self. See, they're just allowed to just be like that. It's just nasty shit, man. It's crazy as fuck. See what I'm saying? So that precept said, this is just the beginning, okay, of the judgment the Most High has for unruly demonic motherfuckers, man. Simple as that. Okay, see, like I said, okay, Esau, you know, he doesn't know too much about the Omicron. He doesn't know too much, okay. But he's talking about, obviously, it spreads, okay, twice as fast, okay. See, but he's obviously doing more research, you see. But obviously, we see the Most High, he's really keeping the spirit on Esau to really, you know, extend this pandemic, to really keep the pandemic going, okay, to keep it, keep it going, see, you know, simple as that, okay. So the Most High, he's continuously doing judgment. Okay, we have a new variant, Omicron and whatnot. Okay, we're going to continuously watch, okay, and see how the Most High unravels different things. Okay, you see, in the future of these prophecies. Okay, suppose that. Okay, so I hope this is edifying. Shalom.
Shalom.